Guys, welcome back to A Complicated Melody. So this is the look that I have for you guys today. It's a very plum, smoldery eye. It's a really nice fall smoky eye. Of course, these are popular looks for the fall, and you can also do them during the day. This look, I think you can do either or. I don't think it's that dark that you can't do it during the day, but it's a great nice look, and it's using a lot of the products from the new A Tartan Tail from MAC for the holiday. So I was requested to use Glamora Castle and Semi Precious. So that's the plum one and the gray one. And so these actually work very well together. I love this plummy, smoldery, smoky eye. I also used the Family Crest, which is also in the new collection. So, and there was one other one. Oh, the Pearl Glide Black Line. So I used that as well. So these are all products in the new A Tartan Tail from MAC. So if you have those, pull those out and we'll get to using those. If you don't have those, you can, if you have a nice gray and a plum color and a darker charcoal color, pull those out, and that will work just the same. And so, so this is the look, and if you want to see how to get it, just keep on watching. Okay, so the first thing, of course, you're going to prime your eye from lid to brow, and I did that with Too Faced Shadow Insurance. So the first color that we're going to use is Glamora Castle, and this is the gray color, and we're just going to cover the entire lid with that. So next we're going to go in with Semi Precious, and this is that nice plum color. You can take a clean blending brush, and it's the E40 from Sigma. So next we're going to go in with the Family Crest. So as you can see, it's a dark gray, almost black with sparkle pigment. So we're going to take this brush, it's called a definer brush from Smashbox. As you can see, it's like a stiff dome brush. You don't need a whole lot of it, and we're going to take that, and you're going to find your crease. I'm going to put that very defined in our crease. You can take your blending brush and blend that out. And we want that purple to stand out, so we can take a little bit more on your blending brush. So next we're going to go in with this color. It's called Vex. It's a light gray iridescent color, and we're going to put that in our inner corner. So next we're going to take a rice paper for our highlight. So we're going to take Black Line, which is the Pearl Glide, and we're going to line our top lid and our lower line. I'm going to take my Chorus Black and line my waterline. So I'm going to take a smudger brush and a little of the Semi Precious, and I'm going to smudge a little bit of that on the lower lash line. So no falsies, I'm going to go in with Dior Show Blackout. Okay guys, so here's the final look. For the blush, I have NARS, and this one is Deep Throat. Like, I just got this in the mail today, and it's a nice light pink color, a little shimmery, not too heavy on the shimmer. So I have that. For the highlight, this is an e.l.f. bronzer called Sun Kiss, and it's actually a great highlighter. This color is just so pretty on the cheeks, and didn't want anything too shimmery. This is just kind of gives you a nice kind of glow in your on your cheekbone. For the lip, I know I used this in another tutorial, but I wanted to use it again just so that people can see kind of what it really looks like, because this one is the Courting Lilac, and it is a glaze. It's a glaze, so it's a lot lighter, I think, than people think it is. If they purchased it online. So one thing that you can do is use Prune by NYX, the lip liner. It's a kind of light purpley mauve color, and I just used it very lightly, just like I did in the last tutorial, and this is kind of the look that you get. So you, and this is a nice couple of swipes across, so I really built it up so that you could kind of see the color, but just one swipe is very, very light, and you may want that as well. So it just depends on what you want your look to look like. And then I topped it with Oyster Girl, and I really love these two together. Oh my gosh, they really, really look pretty. And Oyster Girl is my favorite lip gloss from MAC. So this color I think goes with so many skin tones. It's like a light pink, kind of golden iridescence, like an oyster, obviously. And so it's really, really pretty. So I hope you guys like the look. If you have any questions, please let me know. I also have another tutorial planned with one other color from a Tartan Tail, so we'll see that soon as well. But if you have any other questions or want to see some color combinations, if you have the products and want to see how they're used, just let me know, and I can plan a tutorial around that. And of course you can find me on Twitter, just Melody, complicatedmelody.com. If you're on Beautylicious, just Melody there as well. And thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time.